Hello guys, welcome back to Droid Tips, and in this video we're going to talk about how to fix Like a Dragon Infinite Wealth is having crashing issue. It is not launching, won't launch, freezing, stuttering, lagging, low FPS drop, stuck on loading screen, and even many more issues which is happening for many of users right now, and how we can fix this up. So let's dive into the workaround. The first one, we have to do a restart. For this, we just need to go over here in the start, go over here in the power icon, do a restart. Once the restart is done, just try launching the game, and that is what we have to do. Next one is all about, we have to launch the game from the installation folder. So right now we are launching the game from Steam. So launching the game from Steam might be the issue why you're having the crashing and all these things. So we have to launch the game from the Steam. For this, we just need to go over here in the game, go to the library, right click, and go to the properties, install it file, and just click on the browse. So that will take you to this, and from here, if you close this and if you check over here at the top, there is this PC, local disk C, program file x86, steam apps common, Like a Dragon 8. So just open this particular folder, go for media. Now from here we can launch the game. So this is the application, so just launch the game from here. For many users, in my knowledge, it worked for them, so you can try this out as well. Also, I would like to make you notice two more steps. That is, one is all about we have to run the game as an administrator, and the next one is all about we have to run the game in the compatibility mode. So hence we are in the middle, hence we're in the installation folder. I'll be showing you these two steps. So what you need to do is we just need to select the application or navigate to the installation folder. Once afterwards, just right click over here and go to the show more option, go to properties, go to compatibility, click on run this program as an administrator, and go for apply and go for OK. This is for the first one. If this is not working, try running the game in the compatibility mode. So just go here in the properties, compatibility, click on run this game in the compatibility mode. Either you can try running the game in the Windows 7, or you can try running the game in the Windows 8. Any one of things will be working fine, and go for apply and go for OK. And once afterwards, just close everything, and we have to go back and try launch the game. If that is still not working, we can move to the next one. That is all about we have to launch the game and we have to press Alt and Tab. I don't know how this is related, but this even worked for many users. So just launch the game, press Alt and Tab, and it worked for many users. So you can try this out. Next one, we have to launch, make sure the game is having the date, time, and region is correct. For this, we just need to go over here in the search and navigate to settings, go for time and language, go to the date and time, make sure the time zone, time automatically, all these three things are correct, and also go back, make sure language and region. Now from here, we have to make sure the country or region, we have to set this up into correct. For example, if you're from United States, select United States. If you're from United Kingdom, you have to select United Kingdom. And if you're from any other country, do it accordingly. Afterwards, try launch the game. Still, if you're having the trouble, we can try the next one. That is all about we have to delete the saved game file. Just go over here in the file explorer, navigate to documents, and over here you'll be able to find the folder. So if you're not able to find the folder, just get into the folder my games, and over here you'll be able to find the folder for the game. So just delete the folder. Keep in mind, when you do this, you'll be losing all the progressions of the game and you have to start from the scratch. But even though it's worth a lot, so you can try this out. Next one is all about nothing but we have to allow the game to Windows Security. So just go over here in the game and search for Control Panel, go for System and Security, go for Windows Defender Firewall, go for Allow an App or Feature through Windows Defender Firewall, keep scrolling down and navigate to, hence it is an alphabet, keep scrolling down and navigate to L. Like a Dragon Infinite Wealth is already there, and the private and public both has to be marked. That is what we have to do. So imagine the game is not here, we can add it by default. So just click on the change setting, go for allow another app, go for browse, navigate to this PC, go to local disk C, go to program file x86, go for Steam, navigate to Steam apps, go for common. Now from here we have to select Like a Dragon. Over here we have to select Like a Dragon, select the runtime folder media, and we have to go over here and select this one and go for open and add it. So I'm getting the error because it is added. So make sure both the private and public both has to be selected. And once you select it, you are fine with it. Just go back to the game and try launch the game. So for many users, when they added the game, it worked for them, so you can try this out. And still, if you are having the trouble, what we need to do is we just need to move to the next step. That is all about nothing but what we need to do is we just need to do like this. That is what we need to do is we just need to unplug all the USB devices. So we might be connected with a lot of things. For example, multiple monitors might be connected, multiple controllers might be connected, joysticks might be connected, all the USB ports might be filled with something else, which is causing this kind of issue. So just remove everything, and once you remove everything, launch the game. Afterwards, just connect it back. Once you're in the game and you're good to go with the game, just connect it back and try launching the game. Next one is all about nothing but we have to perform a clean boot. So just go over here. Now from here, go to system configuration, navigate to the services and go for disable all, go for hide all Microsoft services and go for apply and go for OK. Now if you can try, go for a restart. The users are watching this, go for restart, but I'm going to go for exit without restart, then try launching the game. Next one is all about nothing but what we need to do is we just need to disable the Steam overlay. Go over here in the game, right click and go to the properties. Make sure this is turned off, try launch the game, this will be working. If that is not the case, we have one more step. Given the commands in the launch option, so the first command is DX11. You can try giving the DX11, or if DX11 is not working, try giving the command DX12. So either the DX11 will be working, or we have to try with DX12 and that will be working fine as well. Next one is all about we have to close all the overlay application. So you can check over here, go to the start menu, right click and go to the task manager. Now there are a lot of things running in the background. So all these things are actually utilizing the performance, and that is why we are having the crashing issue. So we need to remove the unwanted things, for example, Discord, Riva Tuner, MSI Afterburner, which comes to the category of overclocking and overlay application. Just remove everything. Once afterwards, just launch the game and that will be working fine. Next one is all about we have to run the game on dedicated graphics card. So just go over here in the game, right click and go to the graphics settings. Now from here, we have to add the game. Just click on the browse, go to this PC, local disk C, go to program file x86, go for Steam folder, navigate to Steam apps, go to common. Now from here, go to the game, Like a Dragon. So over here, you'll be able to find Like a Dragon. So select this one, runtime, media. Now select the application over here, open this, add it. Once afterwards, just click to the option, make sure this is high performance has been set. So this is on high performance and go for save. Once afterwards, just close everything and we have to go back, try launching the game. Next one is all about nothing but we have to increase the virtual memory. So just go over here in the search and we have to go for view advanced system setting. Go to the advanced tab and go to the settings and advance it. Go for change. Make sure this is blank and select the local disk where the game is installed. And we have to set the value custom size, which is initial size, that is 1.5 times the throttle RAM, and the maximum size 3 times the throttle RAM. We need a calculator, so just use a calculator. Type the type your RAM, that 32 GB, multiplied with 1024, and we have to multiply it with 1.5, that is 49152. Copy this value and paste it. We have to move to the next one, that is 32 GB multiplied with 1024, and we have to multiply it with 3, that is 98304, and we have to copy this and we have to paste it. Go for OK. And once every value is being set, and we have to try launch the game once again. Even still, if you are having the trouble, you can try updating the graphics card. So I'll be providing a link in the description to both NVIDIA as well as to the AMD. The NVIDIA users has to go to this link, select everything like your product type, product series, product operating system, language, everything should be selected. And once you go for start search, you'll be getting these kind of driver versions available for the download. So you can download the latest one, that is 551.23, which is released on January 24, 2024, few days back. Just download this, install, restart is a mandatory, and try launch the game. And if you're on the AMD, just go over here and go for submit. And you can try Windows 11, you can download this one. And if you're on Windows 10, you can try download with this one. Install, restart is a mandatory, and try launch the game. We can also go over here and try installing the Microsoft Visual C++. But if the system is based on x64, we can download this one. If the system is based on x86, you can try downloading this one and install. Restart is mandatory and try launching the game. Next one is all about nothing but what we need to do is we just need to update the Windows, which is quite important as well. So we just need to go over here in the search and we have to navigate to settings. Now from here, go to the Windows update and just update the Windows. and make sure the Windows is up to date, and you can also try launch the game as well. And also you can try uninstalling the game and reinstalling it back, which worked for many users. So just go over here and go to the manage and uninstall the game. For reinstalling, you have to keep in mind you should not be installing back on the same local disk. You have to try a new local disk. That is what you have to do. Or you have multiple local disks, try from C to D or whatever it is, and that will be just change the position of local disk, then that is what you have to do. And the last and the least one is all about we have to try verify integrity of game file, which is actually a very important step. So just go over here in the game, right click and go to the properties and go to the install it file and just click on the verify integrity of game file. So this will cross check every single files of a game, and if any files are corrupted and if any files are missing, which result in these kind of issues such as crashing, not launching, won't launch, freezing and stuttering, lagging, low face drop, black screen. So these kind of issues will be fixed. So we need to wait because the game is around 78.27 GB. So it's gonna take a little bit of time. So once afterwards, I'll be concluding everything with few more steps. So just wait for this. So once every wildcard successfully validated, just close everything and try launch the game. And these possible workarounds can be done, and I hope this video is helpful. And if you find this video helpful, don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon for more notifications. See you soon in the next video. Peace out. Bye bye.